Hello everyone, in this video, we are going to gain a brief understanding of form workflows in Zoho Creator. Whenever there is a requirement to collect data in any application, forms are used. While developing an application, have you ever come across questions such as how to populate a specific field automatically? How to enable validation messages on submission of a form? How to fetch or update customer data between your Zoho Creator form and other third-party apps automatically? How to disable a form field on specific conditions? How to update a record automatically, such as inventory details after an order is placed, and many more. Most of you would have witnessed such requirements while developing business applications. To resolve such needs, Zoho Creator lets you configure form workflows that will make your forms powerful and dynamic for efficient use. A form workflow, just like it sounds, is connected to the activities that happen in a form. It consists of two parts, events and actions. There are two major events based on which form workflows get triggered, record events and form events. The workflow gets triggered on the specified event and the associated actions get executed. You need to specify the event of record for the form workflow to be triggered. The events of record called record events are of four types. They are created, when you need the workflow to be triggered at the event of creating a new record. Edited, when you need the workflow to be triggered on editing a record. Created or edited, when you need the workflow to be triggered on both creating a new record and editing an existing record in the form. And deleted, when you need the workflow to trigger whenever a record gets deleted. Based on the record event chosen, you will have a series of instances during which you can trigger the workflow. They are known as form events. They are categorized based on the time of form submission as before, on, and after submission of a form. Before submitting a form, the following form events can be performed. Field rules. These are used when you need to set actions on a specific field. Here, you can hide or show, enable or disable, and even set a value to a field. Load of the form. These are used when actions are to be triggered whenever a form gets loaded on the application. User input of a field. You can use this form event when actions are to be triggered every time data is entered on a specific field. Addition of a row and deletion of a row. When a row has to be added or deleted respectively whenever a specific action takes place. Remember, these two actions will be available only for forms with subform field. Next, on the submission of a form, validations can be customized and triggered. For instance, when a record shouldn't be deleted, a message can be displayed on every attempt to delete it. Or when the required number exceeds the inventory count available while placing an order, a validation message stating the same can be shown. After successful submission of a form, actions such as sending an email, updating a record, or mail can be triggered for all the record events. Additionally, you can set actions to update a field when a record gets edited. These are the form events available in Zoho Creator. Once a record event and its form event are selected, actions specific to the latter can be selected. All the actions pertaining to form events are categorized based on the type of actions performed. These are notification, data access, integrations, and delete script. So, what are these? Let's get into a brief detail. Notifications are the action type that enables your application to send notification in the form of email, SMS, mobile notification, success message, and redirect to a URL. Data access refers to the action type that are triggered in order to add record, update the existing value of a record, or delete a record on another form when the criteria is met. Integrations are nothing but the functionality to integrate your applications with one of the four available external applications that include QuickBooks, Salesforce, Zoho CRM, and Zoho Recruit. You can add a record to any of these with the help of integrations in Zoho Creator. Delete script is an action type used when you need to customize specific actions beyond the available action types. Say, update the remaining available leaves every time a leave gets approved. You may use the delete script to define custom logic in your app. The events and actions together form the form workflow. All these are accessible in regular forms. However, in the stateless forms, where the data won't be saved to the created application, you will have access only to field rules, notifications, data access, integrations, and delete script on load of the form, user input, and click of a button. This is just a sneak peek into the various capabilities of form workflows. Hope you got a brief understanding of it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.